The piece was composed in the summer of 2010, and I used the techniques that I've been exploring for some years now, which involve genetic algorithms. So I write a computer program that helps me compose the piece. I happened upon score for Tchaikovsky's piano pieces for young people, Opus 39, that actually had been music that my wife had played as a young child learning to play the piano. So she happened to have that around. And I took some tunes from the Tchaikovsky, and then I used them as, along with other material that I wrote, as what's called the initial population in the genetic algorithm. So if you're thinking about a population of whatever kind of creatures, zebras or something, Serengeti, there's a group of them, and this is your initial population. Of course, they breed and they produce offspring and further generations. So that's what the program does with the material. It takes the material. The material has to be segmented into individuals, and then these individuals breed and produce the next generation, and that generation produces the next generation, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera.
Tchaikovsky was influenced by Liszt. Rodion Washka was influenced by Tchaikovsky. And here we see, you know, the whole chain of influences, and we can trace it all the way maybe to Bach, how the music was composed and how it's composed nowadays. Obviously, Rodney has a very unique way to compose. He uses algorithms and then he makes music out of mathematical patterns. I like the energy of this piece. I like its rhythms, and I expect it will be very interesting to put together with the orchestra.
One of the reasons that I really like having my music played in Europe, and I get a lot of performances in Europe, is because very often the halls there have a tremendous history. And in this particular case, the premiere of the piece is going to be in Glinka Hall, which has a wonderful, wonderful history. It's in St. Petersburg, and it's been used as a concert hall for quite some time, for hundreds of years. It hosted the Russian premiere of Beethoven's Ninth Symphony. All of the great performers of the 19th century played there. So when they would come to St. Petersburg, Russia, they would play there. So Franz Liszt played there, Thalberg, lots of other great piano players as well as violin players. So this is a wonderful chance for the first performance of a new piece that I've composed, first chance for Olga to play in a really historic hall with fabulous acoustics. And this sense of tradition that is palpable to me. When I'm there, I feel like I could go around a corner and see Tchaikovsky at any moment, or Mussorgsky, or someone else. It's a completely different and very electric feeling.